Welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I realize I forgot to get Rutice from the inn. I don't know if we're supposed to be getting her. I wonder if we get a reminder if we try to leave. Yep. Right. We must meet up with Rutice. She said she would be waiting at the inn. Alright, so that's good. And we'll have two members in the party again. Alright, the inn is down here and through and then up. Is this the inn? One second. Yes. Yeah, it's the same. Yo, Ruka. Not Ruka, Rutice. Ruka's the brother. Rutice says, Ruka, Rutice is brooding over something, wearing a sad look. Rutice. Oh my! It's you. You scared me. Where's Lucius, by the way? Well, something came up. Avin explained to her about the request from the plant manager. I see. You're going to the sorcery school. Yes, and she is in the mine. Vanquishing the monsters inside the Guia mine. Then I'll come with you. You can wait here if you want. No, I can't take advantage of your kindness anymore. Besides, all these negative ideas come up when I'm alone. That's because you try too hard to put on a bold front. Ruka was very worried about you. Why don't you throw away your pride and see him? No, I've already made up my mind. Was he doing okay? Yeah, the injury had healed completely. Knowing that is good enough for me. Let's head for the sorcery school. Rutice, join the party. Okay, let's go. Very treacherous stairs these people have. Oh god. These things go fast, too. Missed. Good. There's only two of us. Really wants to bind people. Oh boy. I don't know if she can defeat these things by herself. Wow, I don't know if we... I don't know what gets rid of paralysis. Rebleef, maybe? I'm not sure. I could be wasting it. Oh, if they bind her, too. Missed. Oh, that works! The Rebleef. Sweet. Yeah, that's all this thing does. Take that. Were we going this way? Wait. Oh, we're heading up this way. Never mind. Turns around and goes north. I only know it so well because we were just here last episode. Back again. I just read that last time. And he's the guy. Oh, we're supposed to be talking to him. I guess we still have classes in session. Avin says, we are here to deliver a letter to the president. Oh, thank you. The president is in the east building you see from the entrance. Could you please give the letter directly to him? That's what we were planning on doing. Can we go in the rooms yet? Oh, we can. Nice. Same book here. An overview of black spells. Yeah. Now we can talk to these people. We learned about an ancient people called the Blue Tribe in a lecture given by Professor Elenoa the other day. They had prospered before the church and royal family. However, all of a sudden they disappeared from the face of history, as if they fell to the bottom of the ocean. An ancient tribe that disappeared in the ocean, it's a bit romantic. How's that? A rumor has it that Marty passed the minister's exam. He botches sometimes, but he was still one of the best students in the history of the sorcery school. His passing the exam doesn't surprise me at all. I want to sit for the minister's exam myself, but I don't have Marty's brain. I have a second thought. Okay. How many thoughts does Marty have? What shall I do after graduating from this school? I want to take the minister's exam, but the test is hard to pass. I can become an adventurer by taking advantage of my spell power, but then I must fight with monsters. I think a stable job will be better for me. Professor Gaston's lectures are too formal, and I get choked. Professor Maggot is lazy, but he never misses the key points. If he stops skipping his lectures, he will be a great teacher. Oh, so he's a professor at the sorcery school. He's all the way in Guia right now. White spells, yeah. Let's just check with this gardener one more time, just in case he has anything new to say. The front garden of the Grand Cathedral in Vaught is very well maintained, they say. As a gardener, I'd love to see it with my own eyes. Well, then get your butt over there and see it with your eyes. He did have something new to say. Oh. No thanks. No thanks again. Can't get through there. Oh, these people. Professor Maggot continues to skip his lectures. We are educators before researchers. He lacks self-awareness as a teacher. I must guide him as his senior colleague. Amazing, they tell us so much. Professor Gaston has a lot of complaint, but he is actually worried sick about Professor Maggot. I can't believe the professor's name is Professor Maggot. Of course it's spelled wrong, but... I shouldn't say this in front of teachers, but he sounds like a stubborn father who is scolding his indolent son. Say in front of teachers? Well, why not teachers? We are adventurers. Oh, I forgot to look at the letter. Oh, I remember you. You're a friend of Professor Elenoa's. That's right. I came to deliver you the letter from the plant manager in Guia. Really? A letter for me from the plant manager in Guia? I just repeated it back. I wonder what it is. Avin handed a manager note. I don't think we could have read it. We just give it like a description. This is the note given by such and such to give to President Cyan. Well, it says sorcery can aid the processing of rare metal. He wants to stabilize the crystallization process using the force field generated by a spell. Based on this method, we may be able to produce a sword made of rare metal, provided that we have a talented sorcerer. Can you help us? Asked Rutice. I have always wanted to deepen our relationship with Guia's factory. We will gladly offer our services. Let me see. I remember Professor Elenoa knows the plant manager. She is a perfect person to represent the school. Professor Elenoa, says Avin. Certainly she is a reliable person. Unfortunately, she is now in Karuna Village to conduct academic research. Could you please wait here until she comes back? Avin says, then why don't we go to Karuna to bring her back? This way she can get started sooner. Will you do that for us? Please send my regard to her. I guess we're going to Karuna. I'll also explore other options on how to refine rare metal. If I come up with a better idea, I'll contact Guia's factory. Well, good for you. That's all I have to say. Good for you. Oh, I missed an item from the kitty. Probably something I was going to throw away. Oh, I didn't mean to run into you. But since I did, now I have to kill you. Use up some finishing moves here. I destroy all that I catch. Missed. Oh, and you know, she left the party. What's her name? I keep forgetting her name. Lucius, because I think of Lucius as a male's name, so I have trouble remembering. But, yeah, she had, like, 2 experience points left. To level up. It's pretty sad. And then she left the party. We'll be heading this way. We might end up back at the school again. Because I forgot which way I was going. This is probably the school, I think. No. Okay, good. I was certain I was heading back there. Alright, so we gotta look for the next sign. Let's see how to get to Karuna. North! We go northish. Karuna Mountain Path. No thanks. this is a dead end. I'm gonna go north more, because it said north. This is the dead end here. Just want to check, make sure it's Karuna. There's things in the way. Yep. Rutice says, this is Karuna Village. The cold weather is pretty severe. Avin says, there's also a frozen palace in the back of the village. Professor Elenoa must be somewhere around here. Let's find her. Yeah, I remember this place. The place with the dogs, right? I saw a female professor of the sorcery school going into the ice palace in the back. I think a woman with education is pretty cool. Yeah, I agree. There is a stone figure of spirit god Durga. Are we gonna end up fighting Durga now? Oh, there's one of those dogs. Coo, coo. Why does the dog coo? Oh, is he training them? Bow. Bow wow. Bow wow wow. Bark. A female professor with blue hair? She just passed by. She was with that blonde mischievous kid. Blonde mischievous kid. This is a countryside, but I keep a wide variety of goods in stock, which compares favorably with Guia. Woof woof. Bow. I will not bow before you. If you want your dog to listen to you, don't get angry, but give him a compliment. If you don't discipline at all, he will get lazy though. Alright, I'll keep that in mind. I always thought freshwater fish would smell like mud, but since this river is clean, it tastes very good. All the blessings are from Durga. We must thank her. Hmm. No one else in here, right? I just saw the professor with blue hair going inside the palace with a blonde hair boy. A blonde hair boy. She's been here before, but her beauty hasn't changed a bit. She seems intelligent, gentle, and cool. I wonder how I could get acquainted with her. Don't think you're her type. Alright, so that's that place. Yeah. Oh, what about this person? The other day my dog obeyed my command for the first time. I felt like I could communicate with him heart to heart. Alright, let's get out of the water. Since my husband passed away, I've been living here alone, but my life in Karuna is filled with joy. Children in the village come to hang out at my house, and young people share fresh fish and vegetables with me. In return, I mend their clothes and knit warm sweaters. By the way, you all look tired. I'll make some tea, so please relax here a while. Okay, sure. Come visit me again when you're tired. I'll make some tea for you. Did she say anything else? Karuna is a very good place to live. We've got cute dogs, too. Cute dogs. Alright, so the ice palace is back here. Who's the blonde-haired boy? Oh, that actually surprised me. A little startled me, almost. I wasn't expecting to hear that. I think it's cool, though. The, footsteps. Dead end. Well, so much for sneaking up at people on that snow. Just looking around in case there's any chest or something. For a chest or something like that. Goodies. Oh, she's over there. We could almost walk around the whole place from this side. Oh, it's the same here. I'm not seeing anything. Who is that? I should probably know who that is, but I don't. Oh, it's Rael! Oh, that kid! I remember you. Professor Elenoa, I'm cold. It's a waste of time to check this garbage. Stop, Rael. Oh, she is pretty, yeah. Sexually. As far as looks, she's my favorite NPC. You came with us forcibly, but you get tired so fast. Avin down? Look, cause he's down there, not up on the dais or whatever. That's Rael as usual, he says. Avin! Was that the way it was? It was more like, Avin or something. Hooray, that's Avin. I didn't expect to see you here. What's up, Rael? It's good to see you with full energy as usual. I hope you're not causing trouble to your teacher. Nah, I've been a good boy. Liar, says Elenoa. Avin, long time no see. It's good to see you. It's good to see you again too, Professor Elenoa. Who's that girl? Says Rael. Elenoa says, you are Ruka's... I'm Rutice. Ah, you are Ruka's sister? Says Rael. How come you are with Avin? Besides, did you find him, El? Avin says, don't ask me all the questions at once. Let's move to somewhere we can talk. Elenoa says, good idea. Let's go to the chapel in the village. That stuff is glowing or something. Avin goes, what? Oh boy, we have to fight something. What's that stuff? Oh, they came out of Avon's inventory? Oh. What the hell? Avin says it's a boy? Where am I? It's a pretty scary place. Old man's voice says, Avin! Avin says, you are... Because of my incompetence, I let the beautiful cathedral fall into the hands of Bellius. I made both you and Amel suffer, too. Oh, it's Asparius. I'm very sorry, truly. Sorry. Please wait, Sir Asparius. Oh. He's gone. Can't even see the ground. It's like he's walking on air. Avin! This voice is... Old man? Old man Lemuris. It's been a while, Avin. This is Hades, a space between the life and death ruled by Durga. What? We are both dead and alive. We are normally unable to communicate, but thanks to Durga, here we are able to. Avin, it looks like you are going through a lot during this journey. Old man, I... Don't worry. You are my proud disciple. I know you will accomplish your mission. Old man, wait. Please, don't go. He's not listening to you. Ah! You have another old man's voice coming? Old man? Oh, a mean voice. Look at you now. Bellius? Oh, you are Bernard? Is that the same guy who overwhelmed me? Pity you. You are just a kid like I thought you are. I can't believe Rutice took the side of such a boy. She's really coming down. What did you say? If you don't want me to call you a kid, be like a man a little more. If Rutice would lose her life because of you, I will never forgive you for it. I actually... about her... You actually care about her? Is that what you're trying to say? You're breaking up a little bit? Bernard, you are... gone? Who else are we gonna run into over here? Or in here? Is he, like, dreaming this? Oh, he was just transported to this place? The voice of a woman says, please, release him. Who keeps walking on a bloody path because of me? Please save him. Who are you? I was wrong. I thought I could save him by losing my life, but... I drove him, Madrim, into the edge. Madrim? Then you are Dominique? We can't repeat the same tragedy. Please, rescue the girl who succeeded me. Dominique. She was the Durga's daughter before Imel. Hmm. I don't know how to read that. Just exclamation points with no words. Is that Mile? Yeah. Avin, long time no see. Ah! You are dead. I'm sorry, Avin. I couldn't protect Imel till the end. You did a great job. You did protect both me and Imel. I'll rescue Imel with my life that you protected. I feel relieved, Avin. That's the only thing I was anxious about. I really wanted to accompany you till the end of the journey. But I guess it's too much to ask. Oh no, Mile. Ah, this doesn't mean he's really dead. No spoilers, please, guys. I hear a voice. Why, me? Wow. What's going on, Mile? Be careful, Avin. They might be... Mile, what's wrong? Mile! The voice of Rutice saying, Avin, what's wrong? Rael saying, Avin, pull yourself together. Avin says, where am I? Pull yourself together, Rutice says. You were in the ice palace of Durga. All of a sudden, you were about to fall. Avin says, hey, wait a minute. I remember the sacred treasure came out and... Avin looked for them in his inner pocket. Cabeza? Kurupo? Telepied? I've got all three. Rael says, Avin, are you sure you're alright? Was I... dreaming? I was in a chilly cave, and people I know appeared one after another and... Huh? I can't remember who appeared. Oh, he doesn't even remember anyone he talked to, including Mile? Elenoa says, let's just go back to the village now. Please let us hear all of the details there. Avin tried to recall what his dream was about on the way to the chapel in the village, but he could only remember vaguely, as if there was a fog covering his head. So as I remember talking to Mile, upon their arrival at the chapel in the village, Avin told Elenoa and Rael what? Just ended. Rael sobbing, poor guys, both Mile and Avin. Elenoa says, I'm really sorry that you had to go through all that. I understand about the rare metal sword. I'll be happy to help you. Rael says, I'll help you too. We'll have the strength of 100 men with the help of spells. Rael, says Elenoa. Rael says, you can't say anything about it. I'll help them no matter what. Okay, says Elenoa. I intend to have you help them too. The enormous spell power will be necessary to produce the rare metal sword. Nyahaha, there you go, says Rael. Avin says, thanks, you two. Elenoa says, this is nothing. Besides, you've done so many things for us. Let's go to the factory in Guia right away, then. Rael and Elenoa join the party. Sweet. Alright, so... how about we talk to all the human people, or the human figures, again? Uh-oh, you don't look good. What's wrong? Avin says, yeah, I'm fine. I'm just cold because I just came back from the back of the palace. Be careful. Don't overwork yourself. You'll catch a cold, even though you are young. Yeah, young people can catch colds, too. Hey, kid. You look cold. Rael says, yeah, I just came back from the ice palace. It was so cold. I would have let one of them accompany you if you had told me. Hey, kid, why don't you give a dog a hug? The dog says Fluffy. Rael hugs a dog around the neck. Wow, he's warm, says Rael. Hehehe, isn't that so? I don't usually sleep with dogs, but I put them in my bed on cold nights. It's addicting because they are so warm. I'm saying Fluffy now. Alright, let's check with the other people before we leave. I've read that before. My son has come to handle his dog a little. My son's dog has started to obey a couple of his commands. But it's too early to take him to hunting. I'm interested to see what that kid in the other house has to say now that Elenoa is with us. Is he wanted to be introduced to her or something? My child recently started dog handling training. Because of it, he doesn't study anything else. If you could do both, I would be happy. I haven't been able to say anything. That looks like it was cut off too. Guess who's with us? I'm so jealous with that brat. How come I didn't have a teacher who was as beautiful as she is? Elenoa says, oh, you are embarrassing me. Rael says, but she is so annoying and stubborn. Rael, says Elenoa. Elenoa smiled at Rael. Nyahaha, nothing, really. But kid, if you have a teacher like her, would you ever think about skipping school in the morning? Yeah, that's right, hehehe. He didn't even give up saying that stuff, even though Elenoa was with us. I thought he was going to be, like, embarrassed or something, or, like, flustered that she was there. Ah, you were handling dogs the other day. Hehe. After that, I trained myself to have dogs obey me. Wow, that's cool, says Rael. What kinds of things can you do? Shake hands and sit. I don't like to teach my dog to wait, because I have to wait for meals. I guess that's reasonable. Oh, you are the boy I took care of when the dogs acted violently. How are you feeling since then? I'm fine. I'm young, says Rael says. Rael says, thank you for the other day, says Elenoa. You're always so active, Rael. Please stop by when you come to Karuna again. Alright, we're done in here. Okay, so next episode, heading back to Guia, I guess. That's what we're doing. Right, because, Elenoa is going to help with the spell power to forge the rare sword, the rare metal sword. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next episode when we do that stuff. And always, seek adventure.